the main thing that drew me into it was I loved that synopsis of the first movie of a bunch of boys trapped in this environment and nobody knows what's going on, and it's to see how they deal with it and how they create their own little civilization for themselves. I thought that was the most interesting thing. These people are really passionate and also really good, and also young and kind of and loose and happy and willing to have fun. And that's important as well, I think. You know, we're so lucky to be able to do this amazing job and to be able to play these great characters and these wonderful stories. And it is fun. I think it's important to remember to have fun. And we do. So it's like this nice combination of having really good fun and getting along with one another and being aware of how lucky we are. At the same time, when it comes to knuckling down, we all are very professional and take things very seriously. We're all very aware that we're in this kind of special moment. We're all roughly around the same age as well. So we've done a lot of growing up over the years together as well, which has been really nice. It was really cool, actually. It's got such a beautiful landscape, South Africa, and it really lends itself perfectly for making movies. It can look like loads of, as does New Mexico. You know, it's perfect for making things look like a whole bunch of different stuff. It could look like you're on another planet, or it can look like you're in the future, or you're in the past, or and also South Africa's, you know, fairly new to the film industry. Now there's an awful lot of people going there and making movies. So the crew there are also really very enthusiastic. We had a great crew working with us, which makes such a difference. It rubs off on you if people are passionate about a piece. That, you know, works its way down throughout the whole crew and cast. Dylan is a very good mover, and Dylan likes to dance when he's kind of happy, as does Dexter. Dexter's a kind of professional dancer. And again, that's kind of contagious. If someone's just kind of having a little boogie, then you boogie along. They're very much his. And I'm so glad that he got to do all three as well, because it gives some type of continuity to the whole thing as a piece. And it gives a full storyline arc, and it gives a kind of similar mood across the whole board. And he is he was the kind of driving figure. Although he's a very, you know, very quiet, quite shy person, he does have this drive behind him, which is, it's kind of a silly, fun, childlike drive, but it's, I love it. And I think it's really kind of what made these movies what they are. Thomas is still kind of unsure of, he makes decisions, but it's very much spur of the moment. He lives very close to the edge, and Newt's that person that will kind of step in with encouragement, or you know, have some type of opposing view and just make sure that the whole picture has been taken into account properly before a spur of the moment decision is made. I think he's reached this point in his life where, like I said, that's kind of all that matters to him, is his friends and his family that he has got to know. His memories of his past life before are non-existent. I'm sure he did have a family, and I'm sure he loved a lot of people and was loved in return. But when that's taken away from you, all you have is the people around you. And I think that's kind of grown and grown and grown and grown throughout the three movies, and he's reached a point where, that's kind of all that really matters to him, is being around the people whom he loves and cares very much about, and fighting with them and for them, and essentially for the world as well. Thomas is the leader and he pushes us hard, but that there's an awful lot of pressure there, especially if you don't actually know what you're doing or where you're going. So Newt's kind of the person that he'd have a little chat with or rely on to give him a little boost, to give him a push, to keep him going.